In this video, we'll focus on the insights associated with each blueprint and each experiment on the leaderboard. Specifically, we'll look at the performance of a time series experiment and what important features are in the top model. We'll show this first in the graphical user interface and then repeat portions of it in code using the DataRobot Python API. This is important to understand what insights and visualizations are available for each experiment that is run. In this video, we're starting on the Models tab after AutoPilot has finished, and we have 29 completed experiments. Each experiment is the combination of a blueprint and a feature list, and blueprint is an important term for all DataRobot users to understand. When you click on any one row, it'll open to the Describe tab, and you'll see the blueprint. The blueprint provides a graphical representation of the data pre-processing, and each box is clickable for more information. Next, let's go to the Evaluate tab. The Evaluate tab provides key plots and statistics needed to judge and interpret a model's effectiveness. Take some time to explore the options and get familiar with the visualizations. Next, let's go to the Understand tab. The Understand tab explains what drives a model's performance. Be on the lookout for toggles between original and derived features. In the DataRobot documentation, you can learn more about all of the options on the Describe tab, the Evaluate tab, and the Understand tab. We've spent all of our time with this ridge regressor, but all of the visualizations we saw are available for all 28 models on this leaderboard. Now let's do a few of those tasks in a notebook. All of the visualizations we just saw under Describe, Evaluate, and Understand are available through the API in a notebook. However, that's a little out of scope for a getting started series. So in this demonstration, we'll simply retrieve the top model and request the feature impact for that top model and display it as a data frame. It's worth pointing out that all of the charts and visualizations we just saw are available from Predict and Downloads. This is where you can access PNG files as well as the data that supports the graphics in a CSV format. This is why we're not demonstrating how to recreate all those graphics in the notebook. It's a really great feature that a lot of users don't know about. Now you should have basic familiarity with the insights that are available for each time series model in DataRobot.